In this video, we will discuss on seasonal changes of the Earth and the effect of declination as part of general navigation subjects for ESA ATPL, and we are starting right now. The focus of this channel is to provide explanation for ESA ATPL examination and other aviation related stuff. If this is your first time here, consider subscribing to Answering ATPL by clicking the subscribe button and click on the bell icon to get notified when I publish a new video. In the last video, titled Keplers Law, I had shown that the Earth's orbit is shaped like an ellipse. However, the shape of the ellipse in that video is exaggerated to prove the point. In actual, the Earth's orbit around the Sun in near circle orbit as shown on the screen. The distance of the Earth from the Sun at perihelion is approximately 91.6 million statute miles and 94.6 million statute miles at aphelion. When the Earth is at perihelion in January, the nearest point from the Sun, the Northern Hemisphere experiences its winter season, the coldest time of the year. However, when the Earth is at aphelion in July, the furthest point from the Sun, the Northern Hemisphere enjoys its summer season. This clearly shown that the variation of the distance of the Sun from the Earth is not a factor that determines the season. The real reason for seasonal change of the Earth is due to the tilt of the Earth. Before we can discuss the tilt of the Earth, we need to define the plane of ecliptic. The plane on which the Earth orbits around the Sun is known as the plane of ecliptic. This graphic showed the relative position between the Earth's spin axis and plane of ecliptic. The angle between the Earth's spin axis and the plane of ecliptic is 66.5 degrees. The angle between the Earth's spin axis and perpendicular to the plane of ecliptic is 23.5 degrees. If we extend the equator into space, we get another plane. This plane is known as equinoctial. Equinoctial is perpendicular to the Earth's spin axis. The angle between the equinoctial plane and ecliptic plane is also 23.5 degrees and also known as the obliquity of the ecliptic. The Earth's tilt is constant throughout time. This diagram shows four most important positions of the Earth in relation to the Sun within 1 year. On the 21st of June, the center of the Sun is aligned with latitude 23.5 degrees north, and on the 21st of December, the center of the Sun is aligned with latitude 23.5 degrees south. On the 21st of March and 21st of September, the center of the Sun is aligned with the equator. These changes cause unequal heating on the surface of the Earth, which creates seasonal changes. From the perspective of the observer on the surface of the Earth, the Sun appears to be moving between latitude 23.5 degrees north and 23.5 degrees south throughout a year. From this observation, we can define another plane. Declination. Declination is the angle measured northward or southward from the equinoctial to a line joining the center of the Earth to a body in space. Other than affecting the season, constant changes of declination will also affect the length of day and night. On the 21st of June, the Sun reaches its maximum northerly declination at latitude 23.5 degrees north. This latitude is known as the Tropic of Cancer. During this time, the Northern Hemisphere enjoys its summer season. Other than affecting the season, declination also affects the hours of daylight. As you can see in the animation, the hour of daylight in Northern Hemisphere is longer than the hour of daylight in the Southern Hemisphere. This period is sometimes referred to as the Northern Hemisphere summer solstice or Southern Hemisphere winter solstice. Solstice means standing sun. I will explain on this later in the video. Another phenomenon that happened due to declination is the midnight sun phenomenon. north of 66.5 degree north latitude on 21st of June, we experienced sunlight for 24 hours, whereas south of 66.5 degree south latitude will experience 24 hours of darkness. 66.5 degree north latitude is known as the Arctic Circle. On the 21st of December, the sun reaches its maximum southerly declination at 23.5 degrees south. This latitude is known as the Tropic of Capricorn. During this time, the southern hemisphere enjoys its summer season. During this period, the hour of daylight in southern hemisphere is longer than the hour of daylight in the northern hemisphere. This period is sometimes referred to as the southern hemisphere summer solstice or the northern hemisphere winter solstice. Midnight sun phenomenon can be experienced south of latitude 66.5 degrees south on the 21st of December, whereas north of latitude 66.5 degrees north will experience 24 hours of darkness. 66.5 degrees south latitude is known as the Antarctic Circle. On the 21st of March and 21st of September, the declination is 0 degree, which means the center of the sun is directly overhead the equator. On 21st of March, the northern hemisphere experienced spring season and southern hemisphere experienced autumn season. The situation is reversed on the 21st of September. During this period, the length of the day and night are equals. This is where the term equinox came from. Equinox in English means equal night. In the northern hemisphere, this period is known as vernal equinox in March and autumnal equinox in September, whereas in the southern hemisphere, this period is known as autumnal equinox on March and vernal equinox on September. On the 21st of June and 21st of December, the declination of the sun reaches its apex. The sun changes its direction at this time of the year. As the result, from the vantage point of the observer on the surface of the earth, it seems that the sun is stationary. The word solstice is derived from this observation. Solstice in English means standing sun. What do you think of this video? Please let me know in the comment section below. And if you find the video beneficial, please like it and share with others. By doing so, you will help other people to find the video. If you want to learn more about ATPL or other aviation related stuff, subscribe now by clicking on the round subscribe icon. Please check out my other video by clicking on the rectangular box. Thank you so much for watching. I'll see you next time.